but it is time to turn to the Lidl divisional football finals this weekend. Delighted to say OTB's Aisling O'Reilly is on the line. Good morning, Aisling.
Good morning, lads. How are you?
Really good, and really excited for the latest iteration of Dublin Cork this weekend, and reading some of the previews and looking back on what's happened obviously in the last meeting particularly between them. There's nothing between them, and nobody would be surprised if Cork could get it done tomorrow.
Exactly, yeah, definitely, Adrian. It's a repeat of last year's All-Ireland final when Dublin just got on top of Cork last December, it was, and that was their fourth All-Ireland in a row. But Cork are the reigning Division 1 league champions. I think people sometimes forget that. So, you know, they have a lot of experience in the league. And I think it's 12 occasions now that they've appeared in the Division 1 final. And they're going for their 15th time since 2004 to try and win it. Well, say Dublin are chasing just a second little Division 1 title. So sometimes people are a bit surprised by that. But they did meet in the league as well earlier on. And Dublin just edged out by a point. It was in Parky Cueve. Was in round two of the league, so it was such a tight game. But looking back now, Cork might be happy enough that they didn't get over the line that day, that they're going in now tomorrow, you know, maybe as underdogs. I'm sure they are, but I think they'd be happy enough going in like that. You know, they've a lot of experience when it comes to the leagues, and it's definitely going to be a cracking game. But yeah, as you said, both the teams have a wealth of experience, and they will be trying to right those wrongs now from the last year's All-Ireland. And I think from the last year's All-Ireland as well, they went out a bit defensive. They didn't play on the front foot. They were, you know, they're normally very much attacking, and they didn't do that last year. So I hope they play like they've been playing in the league so far. And I definitely think they'll put it up to them. But look, it's hard to look by the doves. They know how to win. And when they're behind, as they were, say, in that previous league game with Cork, you know, they just kept calm. They responded. They get back on top. And then you see the bench as well. They're seriously impressive. Anyone that comes on for them is just as vital for them. So, yeah, they have a lot of competition for places there. So, yeah, it's definitely going to be a cracking game.
It helps when keeping calm helps when you have Hannah Tyrrell to lash in 2-2 in the course of 3 minutes. Any game can turn on that. But like her return, Aisling, and like both players have lost a couple of big names, obviously, but Hannah Tyrrell, particularly for Dublin, and her reacclimatisation from rugby. I mean, there doesn't seem to have been any reacclimatisation. She's right up to speed with it straight away.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. Like, she hasn't played since 2014 for Dublin in Intercounty. So it's just unbelievable to step in there. And her first game that she played for them, she scored 1-5. And then she followed it up, I think was it 6 days later, 2-7 against Cork, you know, in Parky Cueve. So it's just unbelievable. She's taken the frees for them. She's just been massive. And like, they lost the likes of Noelle Healy, who was a major blow for the Dubs. But then you have the likes of Hannah Tyrrell, who's a similar style of play. She plays out on the half-forward line as well. She's very much attacking. She runs up and down the line. She plays similar to Noelle. So, you know, they just literally put Hannah in there, you know, instead of Noelle. So it's unbelievable that you can actually do that in a team. You know, not many counties will be able to do that. So, yeah, obviously we know she played with the Ireland rugby team as well, and she just retired this year as well. So just unbelievable to see what she's done. So, yeah, I'm excited to see her play now in the final and see what she comes up with.
Talk to us about, like, the loss of Sinead Goldrick and Dearne O'Sullivan to either side, like, seems like a big blow. And then actually when you scratch away at it, there's loads of young talent coming through, particularly on the Cork side, and the impact that that'll have, and maybe which side is better equipped in terms of that bubbling up of brilliant young players.
Yeah, I've seen it with Dublin the last few years as well. Niamh Heatherton, she played in the semi-final against Mayo. She's only about, I'd say she's 20 now, and she's been knocking on the door to try to get a place on that team. She started against Mayo in the semi-final, and she got a goal within the first few minutes. And that was her, I think, moment of Mick, you know, putting her hand up, like, I deserve a place here. So she's constantly coming on over the last number of years, and I'd say now she's hoping she'll get that start in the final. But you do have the likes of Eve McAvoy as well. She's coming off the bench a lot when she'd normally be one of their main starting players, but she's coming on and off just because of Hannah. You have Lindsay, you have Sinead up there as well, so it's so tough to be on that team. And then with Cork, it's the same as, you know, you have the likes of Vera O'Shea last year who came on the scene. she blew the place up when she came in, and she's been getting a start in place, you know, the last year, 2 years now, and it's so competitive. So yeah, I wouldn't fancy being on any of those teams trying to get a start in place. It's tough, but any winning team, that's what you want. You know, that's why Dublin and Cork are so successful, because the bench that comes on is just as strong, and that's what you want. You know, you want to be constantly competing for places, and yeah, they definitely have that.
How important is it for Cork to beat this Dublin team pretty soon, to actually get over the line while they are close? Because there is a sense that maybe this gap could perhaps widen over the next little while. Like, we have to remember that Cork are also the most recent winners. They're coming off, they have a winning culture that exists in the county, at least from the last few years or so. They are the best place to take down Dublin, but it kind of feels like they need to do it soon.
Exactly, and I think it's a thing with them that they're actually just like, will we ever do this? Will we ever get over the line? You know, it's that team you have in your head that you just can't get over the line with. But last year, as I was just saying, that they did play that bit defensive, and I think that's wrong going out of a team like against Dublin. You know, you sort of tell them straight away, oh yeah, you're that bit ahead of us here, we need to go out defensive. You know, that's what that gave to me when I was watching against at the All-Ireland last year. So I just hope that they go out on the front foot, they go out attacking, they play like they play against every other team, and they don't change it up too much against the Dubs, because their system is working. And that was just a little thing last year, that they changed the system up. So if they just don't do that, and look, when they're on the attack with the O'Sullivan sisters up front, you know, you have Orla Finn up there as well. She's a brilliant free taker for them. She's under pressure. She's always rose to the top. So if you can just get the likes of them on the ball, and yeah, just play like they played in the league, and don't mind that it's Dublin. Put that to the back of your head. It's another game, you know, and just, yeah, try and get over the line that way rather than building it up so much, because I think sometimes that's what happens, you know.
Yeah, and it's a great rivalry, and that's the latest installation of it. We normally have to rely on Tommy Rooney to overstate the case of Meath football here, and he does it on obviously such a regular basis, but you're about to jump in as well. Ashling, what did Division 2 final Kerry and Meath, and Meath, the rise of Meath football over the last few years, go on. You've got we need somebody to fill the void. You've got the platform.
Okay, you have 2 minutes, go. No, but it is unbelievable. Like, we talk about the men's, that's Tommy constantly, but actually Meath ladies football should be talked about. You know, over the last number of years, they've been in the All-Ireland final the last 3 years. They got over the line last year against Westmeath. That put them up to senior. In 2019, which was the last league because of COVID, wasn't played last year, they won the Division 3, which put them up to Division 2, and now they're in the Division 2 final. Like, it's becoming regular for them to be in Croke Park, which is mad to me. I never seen that growing up, to see me ladies playing in Croke Park, just like it's the norm. So it's brilliant to see. And they're coming up against Kerry, who obviously have been playing senior over the last number of years. And they'll be gunning to get back to Division 1. You know, they got relegated, I think it was 2018. And they'll be really trying to get back up there to try and mix with, you know, the best teams in the country. That's where you want to be. So, yeah, it'll be a really tough game. They did meet earlier on in the league in, it was round one, and Kerry beat Meath by 6 points. But I think now Meath will be happy enough going in there, because it was their first game up against a senior team, say, since they got promoted. It was 6 points. They were missing a few of the girls that day. I think they'll be happy enough going in underdogs. You know, they would rather have lost that game knowing they were going to meet them in the league final. So, yeah, I think they're exciting. They've been together the last number of years now, and they've really stuck together. They went through a bit of a transitional period, but the core group of girls have stuck together, and I'm excited to see what they do. But, yeah, Kerry's going to be a seriously tough opposition, so it'll be a good one to see what the outcome is.
Yeah, and 4,000 fans back, which is really exciting as well this weekend. Are we, after all that, Ashling, looking at a Dublin-Kerry outcomes?
No, I think Meath can do it in Division 2. I think they'll be a bit of a shock there. I think they'll get over the line. It'll be very, very tight. And then with Cork and Dublin, I think Dublin will just edge it. They just have that little bit extra that they'll just edge it. I think the bench will be the difference there, and the likes of Hannah Tyrrell.
All right, well, look, we'll keep an interested eye on it, and no doubt catch up with you again in the not-too-distant future. Ashling, thanks a million.
Thank you.